Hi friends, welcome to the new series JavaScript Hero to Superhero. In this series, I'm explaining about some advanced concepts in JavaScript. If you are a beginner trying to learn JavaScript, there is another series JavaScript Zero to Hero, in which I have explained all the basic concepts. In this video, I'm going to talk about closures in JavaScript. A closure is the combination of a function bundled together with references to its surrounding state, or we can say to its lexical environment. In simple terms, we can say a closure is a function having access to the parent scope, even after the parent function has closed. Let me explain with an example. Let me have a variable a equal to 5, and then a function. Inside that function, let me have another variable b equal to 3, and then let me call that function. Now let me put console.logs inside and outside the function. And let me execute. Now we can see we are able to access the outer variable inside the function, but we are not able to access the inner variable outside the function. This is how JavaScript works because of scope. From this, I just want you to understand that we can access the outside variable inside the function. Now let me show you this one. Let me create an outer function. Inside that, let me create an outer variable. And then let me create an inner function. Inside that inner function, let me print the outer variable. And then let me call the inner function inside outer function. And then outside the outer function, let me call the outer function. And let me also console the outer variable here. Let me execute. We can see it is printing the value of outer variable first, and then it is throwing error, outer variable is not defined. That is because in this line, we are calling the outer function and the execution goes here and call the inner function. And as we have already seen, the function can access its parent state. This inner function can access outer variable. And so it is printing this value. This is a closure. Also, we have already seen we cannot access the variable outside the function. That is why it is throwing error when we try to print it outside. Let me slightly change this code to understand the closures better. Instead of executing the inner function here, let me return that and let me get that outside and execute it outside the function. Now what will happen? Let me execute. We can see the same output. Actually, this outer variable is a local variable to the outer function. Normally, a local variable only exists during the execution of the function. Here we can see at this point, outer function has already been executed. That means it has been already closed. But we are able to access the reference to this variable even after the function is closed. So here, this inner function and its parent state act as a closure. So through this closure mechanism, we are achieving data encapsulation, which is one of the object-oriented programming concepts. We are also going to see some more concepts soon, which use the concept of closures. Hope you understood and you like this video. Please subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.